Keisha at all. She has an interesting life, but she wasn't intriguing to me. Nephi was fascinating, but she was not the focus of my attention. The reason why I watch the show, reason why I watch the way it is, watch ratings go up now. I watch it because of Frankie. Frankie is my girl. Frankie is one that has the challenges of life on her shoulders, but she's learning how to deal with a clean, free life. I'm getting to the point. We're going to sit down. She forgave herself for her past and believed that God forgave her. But her family had to learn how to forgive her for all the pain and suffering that she caused them. Frankie's sins caused terrible repercussions. But Frankie didn't just die and give up. She sought forgiveness between her and God and then with her family. She didn't force anybody to forgive her. She offered the opportunity for them to forgive her. Side note, some people may have been affected by your sin. You forgave yourself. Offer them the opportunity to forgive you. Leave it there. What they do with it is their business. Look at your neighbor and say, leave it there. She said, God made her who she is. And everything that she went through made her a better person. She said the devil tried to get her, but God gave her another chance. So it is a man down situation. What my sermon today is, it's a man down situation. It's a man down situation. Look at your neighbor and say, man down. Received. A man down. Ooh, I'm about to get excited. In other words, the enemy wanted her to cover up her sins and to continue in the lifestyle that was destroying her. But God allowed her to see the error of her ways. With God's help, she defeated the enemy's attempt on her life. Frankie was saying that the devil tried a lot of things to destroy her. She almost lost her children. She almost lost her life. She almost lost her love. But God didn't allow him to win. It's a man down situation. Woo! Frankie never denied her past. She never denied her past. She wasn't happy about her past, but she never denied her past. She accepted the mistakes of the past, but she embraced her future. She believed that her future is much better than anything she could drudge up from her past. See, David said, I've done wrong. I've committed sin that is beyond sin. I tried to cover it up. The enemy manipulated my mind to try to shroud my sins. I tried to act as if nothing ever happened. But when I realized, everybody shout, I realized. When I realized the error of my ways, I asked God for mercy. Everybody say mercy. I asked God for his redemptive power. I asked God for forgiveness, and he restored me. He restored me. See, the one thing that holds us back from our future is dwelling in the past. It's the leniency, compassion, and pity, and forgiveness that moves us from judgment into God's favor. I wish somebody would have grabbed that. Ooh! Look at somebody and say, I'm tired of being judged. I'm tired of being judged. I wish I had two people in here that would lift up your hands and say, I got God's mercy. We deserve exactly what God should have did to us. We deserve exactly what God should do to us. We deserve the punishment that fits the crime. But since God is a merciful God, He extends His favor instead of judgment. He extends His passion instead of revenge. He extends His love instead of punishment. And if the truth be told, some of us should be in time out for years. Because of the things that we have done. But God's mercy showed us just how willing and committed He is to allowing us to have His mercy. Look at somebody and say, I got God's mercy. Look at somebody else and say, I got God's mercy.
That nobody know that you committed.
Look at your neighbor and say, you don't know about this one, but I thank Him for His mercy. Y'all better thank Him for all those skeletons that was in your closet that He didn't let come out. Y'all better thank Him for all that dirt that was swept under the rug. Y'all better thank Him for all that sin. Yeah, that wood that you gonna take with you to your grave. You better thank Him. I said you better thank Him. I said you better thank Him. Because if it had not been for the Lord, I said if it had not been, He wants you to stay feeling shameful. He wants you to be guilty over your past so that you'll never see the future, the brightness of your future. But you need to look at that ugly booger in the eye and say, you silly rabbit, tricks are for kids. Look at somebody and say, tricks are for kids. I've been forgiven. Raise your hands and say, I've been forgiven. I've got His mercy. Yes, I do. I've got His grace. And what the devil meant for evil, God, He meant it unto my good. So therefore, I came to tell the devil that it's a man down situation. I wish you look at the devil in the eye, and I wish you open up your mouth and say, it's a man down situation. Look at somebody and act like you know.
I've come to make an announcement.
When I say man down, that means that you are defeated. I came to tell somebody, I want to prophesy over your life today, that whatever the devil thought that he can do to you, baby, you got something inside of you that is greater than he that is within the earth. And I came to prophesy over your life that it's a man down situation for the devil. I wish you grab your neighbor's hand and say, neighbor,
and
take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of my salvation, and I will uphold him with thy free spirit. I came to tell you that if it's a man, just touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, you got your joy back. And say, I got my joy back. Touch somebody and say, I got my joy back. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Yeah.